So what is something you, if you could go back in time, you would tell yourself? Say, let's say when you had your first kid, what would you tell yourself now?
What would I tell my first child?
No, what's something you would tell yourself if you could go back as a young
Birth
mom?
control.
My name is Molly. Welcome back to my channel. I am new to YouTube and this will be my second video. If you're new, please visit my channel and watch my first video and subscribe and hit the bell so that it reminds you when every time I make a video. Oh, they're angry. This is my daughter, Joanna, and she's angry. Why are you angry? If you follow this video, you will see a day in the life video, just kind of a vlog slash just a small video showing what we did that day. And at the end of this video, you will see a interview with my grandmother that I call Nanny. She is... Are you okay now? Yes or no? Okay. And I have a small interview at the end of this video, like I said, so just follow along. And if you don't want to watch a day in the life video, just skip ahead and it's at the very end.
I don't know what possessed me to leave her in her crib without a diaper, but she has peed all in her bed. So that's great. We are all ready to go. Amy, aren't we ready to go? Lord, I warmed that thing up like 10 minutes ago and it's still going. She loved all her toys.
We are headed out. We're going to the local elementary school to actually read some books to a class I used to work in. When I had my baby, I was a parapro for special education, and I dropped down to being a substitute so that I could spend more time with my daughter and I had more flexible hours. So now we're gonna go see my old classroom and we're going to read them a book. So stay tuned and we'll be doing that.
Dear B,
Hey, I'm back. We are walking down the road, getting some exercise in. It's really not that cold out here, but I'm a wuss and I hate the cold.
Say that word.
Wuss? Yeah. This is my mom. And she doesn't believe you should say wuss on camera. I don't know why.
At all.
But little Joanna, say hey. She said, don't cover me up. It's really not that cold.
That wind.
It's not windy right now.
No, it ain't. It's just blowing the...
But we're just gonna do some walking down the road and I'll probably vlog a little when I get back to the house.
Thank you.
grandmother, which I call her nanny, and her name is
Joyce McGee.
She is a Cedar Town veteran. And I'm going to be asking her a couple questions today based on her life and how she brought everybody in my family to life. So just sit back and relax and enjoy our Q&A we got going on here. Okay, so my first question is, how old are you?
I'm 72.
72. You never ask a lady how old she is unless you're in front of everybody on YouTube. So how many siblings do you have? And name them, and name their, like, gender and everything.
Okay, name each one. Okay. Ann Costello is my oldest sister. My next sister is Betty. Anyways, my next sibling is Carl and Welchel, then John Lindsay, and then myself. And I have a brother who is the oldest, Albert Packer Jr., and he passed away last year.
My Aunt Joan, my great Aunt Joan, is my nanny's twin. They're fraternal twins. When were y'all born? What year?
September 1945.
1945. What was it like being twins in 1945?
Well, we were best friends. We've always been best friends from the time we were very small.
Wow. Okay, so here is another question. How, what age did you meet Pawpaw?
I was 15.
And how old was he?
14.
He was 14. And how did y'all meet?
He rode the bus with me when we were going to school.
Oh, okay. So what age did you have your first child?
18.
You were 18. What, and that was my Uncle Brian. She has four children, and my daddy is the last of her children. Who was the first person that you told you were pregnant?
John.
Who did you tell, but who was the next, like?
I think my mother, I'm not sure. No, John. It was John.
That's her twin sister. How did they react to finding out you were pregnant?
Oh, they were thrilled.
Your parents were? What was it like being a teen mom? And
a lot different than it is today, and you felt more responsible then.
Yeah, I know, because now some teen moms think that they can just drop it off on anybody, and I'm sure back then it was like you do what you gotta do.
Yeah, you become a mother, you were a mother.
Right. How did Papa ask you to marry him?
He just said, let's get married.
That's pretty much how Bryce asked me to marry him. Let's get married.
He wasn't real romantic.
Yeah. All in love, a bad name. How did y'all get married? Like, where did y'all go?
At the Justice of the Peace in Cedar Town.
Who went with you?
My mother.
Your mama? What was your first job?
I worked, John broke his leg, and up until that point, I had never worked. And I went to work at a little convenience store for a little while until he went back to work.
Oh, okay. What was your biggest fear as a child, and what is your biggest fear now?
My biggest fear as a child, my granddaddy was kind of a religious fanatic, and he was always talking about the world ending, and that got on my mind, and I was worried about that for a long time.
So what's the scariest way you can think of the world ending? What's your biggest fear now as an adult?
Something happening to one of my children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren.
Yeah. Tell them how many children you have in order.
4 children, 10 great-grandchildren, 10.
Yeah, I think it's 10.
10 grandchildren, and then I have
13
great-grandchildren, I think. I just had 3 this past year.
And then you got one on the way.
And then another one on the way this year.
What is something if you could go back in time, you would tell yourself? Let's say when you had your first kid, what would you tell yourself now?
Would I tell my first child?
No, what's something you would tell yourself if you could go back? As a young
birth mom. Control.
Oh my gosh. Okay. too much. This question is probably going to be the same answer. What is a piece of advice you would give me as a young parent?
Don't have more children than you can afford.
Yeah, that's a big one. okay. No, that's perfect. Okay, what was it like having deaf children back? I know now it's like
more common
and people like have more resources. What was it like back then?
Well, it was a little harder than it is now, but I met Mr. Whitworth at Georgia School for the Deaf, and he really kind of guided us in what was the best way to do.
Yeah. Both of my daddy's sisters are deaf, and their deafness was caused by like a childhood
mumps.
It was caused by mumps, which they vaccinate for now, don't they?
Yeah,
or it's in like one of the vaccinations. So you don't have to worry about mumps nowadays, but both of his sisters got mumps when they were young children. Which caused almost complete deafness, right? So they wear hearing aids, and they both work for the deaf schools, locally and far away. So they've really made good lives for themselves, and it's kind of taught all of our family a little bit of, I guess without them, we wouldn't have had any, like, we wouldn't have known another language. We've all kind of learned sign language. I'm not as fluent, but my nanny can speak sign language like it's no problem. And all of my aunt's children can speak sign language fluently. So the last question I have is...
You have another one.
Huh?
You have another one.
What is your goal in life going forward from this point?
To live the best I can. Live the best I can.
That is all I have for today. I want to thank my nanny for coming and talking with me today. And I hope that you all enjoy this video. All right, so if you're watching this, please subscribe and touch the bell above so that you get a reminder every time I post a new video. Please like this video if you liked it. And if you didn't, please still like it because I need likes. And I will see you all again on my next video.